There's nowhere at all I'd rather be today than here at Hockenheim for the German Grand Prix. We have an incredibly competitive field this year, which means we should be in for a treat. And judging by the sea of people filling the grandstands, there's a fair-sized chunk of Germany that agrees with me. We're racing in the Rhine Valley this weekend, at the home of many of the sport's finest competitors. The 2.8-mile Hockenheim Ring requires precision through the technical stadium section and great raw speed down the long, flat-out curve towards the popular overtaking zone of the Turn 6 hairpin. Watch out for a lot of wheel-to-wheel action there today. A warm welcome to Anthony Davidson, who's beside me in the commentary box today. Let's talk about Mercedes. They've had one retirement in the last five races. What do you think that says about the reliability of their car?
It's a good statistic for sure, as it demonstrates not only mechanical reliability, but consistency from both drivers as well. These are two of the first boxes you have to tick for any successful season.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. Sebastian Vettel has a clear track ahead of him today. He starts in pole position, and Kimi Raikkonen completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Alonso, Ricciardo, Lewis Hamilton, and Hülkenberg, Sainz, and a McLaren, Bottas, and Roman Grosjean, Verstappen, Leclerc, Kevin Magnussen, and Ericsson, Perez, Stroll, Pierre Gasly, and Esteban Ocon, Hartley, and Sergei Sirotkin rounds off the grid.
Zdravím vás zase, ještě si zůstáte na Anglicka, vás vítám u 11. závodu 5. sezóny mé kariéry v F1 2018 a budeme mít tady zajímavé počasí v Hockenheimringu. No od 5. sezóny závodu by mělo začít pršet. A otázka bude, ve kterém kole to přesně bude. Já teď jdu poupravit strategii. Ono se zase prohodilo a na ten první stint asi nasadím. Jo. Softy. No, otázka bude. Tak začneme tady teďka na softech, ale důležitou otázkou bude, kdy ten déšť přijde.
Let me know you're all right. Thank you. Nice move. Good job. Has been enabled. Is forecast in just over 10 minutes time. has come in. They're now on the soft tyre, softs on the car behind. The gap to the car ahead is 5.2 seconds. Deployment. Fernando's in for his stop. Illegal. Return the position. Window, you'll be on the ultra softs. Gap to teammate behind is 7.4 seconds. Our gap behind is 4.4 seconds. Right, some information on Ricardo. They're slowing down. It seems like there's some kind of problem with their car. ERS deployment. It's time to use some of this charge. virtual safety car deployed. Slow down and maintain a positive delta. Virtual safety car is deployed. Speed, our delta is too low and we risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending. Wait for green. In this lap, push now. Race is over. He's had to retire the car. Pit now. Place is 11.5 seconds. Still on the right tyres for the time being. there's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Got that confirmed? Racing on the exit. Pit strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now. Stewards have now disabled DRS. DRS is now disabled. To the car behind is 1.5 seconds. This is your final lap of the race. lap of fuel remaining. Good. Good job. Nice overtake. Complain about that one. That was an excellent drive.
A great win then for the Maranello team today. So, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
Rain always has the potential to liven up a race and mix up the order, and they've taken full advantage of that to claim the victory today. It's always a bit of a lottery when the conditions are like this, but they've managed to stay on circuit and have come out on top.
So, here they come now, out onto the podium. Wherever you go, anywhere in the world, the Prancing Horse flags are dominant in the grandstands, and they're out in force again today. It's Ferrari on the top step once more. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. It wasn't the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Well, after a drive like that, it's got to be Max Verstappen, hasn't it? Very clean, very smooth. He can be really pleased with that one.
On to the constructors then. Ferrari extend their lead at the top of the championship. After all that excitement, it's time for a lie down, I think. Thanks for joining us, and goodbye until the next race.
Good day today. Tell us about it from your perspective. The weather was miserable today, but do you feel this was an advantage for you? It wasn't the cleanest race today, was it? Well, thanks anyway.
Just wanted to say congrats on the podium. It's thoroughly deserved. We were sweating those last few laps on the pit wall, but you brought it home.